Hello everyone, this is week 62 on the Real DVD Watchers. This week I'm reviewing Dead Like Me, Life After Death. Now, Dead Like Me, Life After Death takes place 5 years where Dead Like Me, the series, started. Yeah, so George has been a Reaper for 5 years, and, you know, if you've seen Dead Like Me, the series, and you'll probably know what I'm talking about, but if you haven't, this will probably just be right over your head. But anyway, takes place 5 years after, and I had initially heard that this film wasn't very good, but I was like, you know, I'm a Dead Like Me fan, I'm gonna buy it anyway and I'm gonna watch it. But I actually got it for Christmas, but I just watched it there a couple nights ago, and it wouldn't have been the way I would have done it. You know, I don't know what I would have come up with for a story, but it just, this movie suffered through so many, like, alright, for one, Mandy Patinkin is not in this film as Rube at all, so you don't see him, and he was, you know, one of the great parts of the series. He's just gone. Like, he had scheduling conflicts or something, because he was on Criminal Minds. He was the lead star on there, so they couldn't get him. And second, they recast Daisy, because Laura Harris was on the Women's Murder Club, and they recast what's her face, Sarah Winter, as the role of Daisy, and that was bad, because you just have this one actress who played the character for 2 years, made it her own, then you have another actress coming in, like, trying to do what she did, and it failed miserably. You don't have Laura, alright, they probably could have just introduced a new Reaper and just say Daisy's away on business or something, or maybe say Daisy got her promoted, like what they did with Rube. But I actually really hated that they did that they should have just waited until Mandy Patinkin became available and Laura Harris and done the movie. Instead, just, you know, giving fans something like this. And I actually would have, you know, if it takes longer to put out, I'll still watch it. But basically, like, the best parts of this film are George's interaction with her sister, and, you know, like, where they go with that. And so I actually would have made this movie talk about all the stuff I would have done, but along with having Mandy Patinkin and Laura Harris, I would have also made it a little longer. Like, it just seemed to really fly by. Like, at 87 minutes, it's like, wow, that was quick. You know, maybe make it like 15, 20 minutes longer. But yeah, that's just what I would have done. Like, the main cast, like, you have George, Ellen Muth, Callum Blue, and Jasmine Guy. Like, they were all brilliant, like, you know, they still had it, like, in their roles. But, like, the whole chemistry between Mason and Daisy was now gone because of the recast, and, you know, they didn't really explore anything there, towards, like, at the end of the film, you know, you kind of get a sense of what, you know, what's to come, like, or what happened, and hopefully they'll make another film. I'll definitely watch it, and hopefully they can get some of the cast back for it. But that was my review of Dead Like Me, Life After Death. And if you haven't seen the TV series Dead Like Me, I highly recommend it. It's brilliant. Just so sad that it was that short-lived. So, that was my review of Dead Like Me, Life After Death. For a rating, I'm gonna give it a 6. That's probably a little generous, but 6, I can't give Dead Like Me anything under that. So, thank you for watching, and look out for Ferg's vid tomorrow. Have a good one.